Welcome to the installation video for Seismic's Pursuit Night Vision Series Side View Mirrors. These directions are for SKU 18086 and 18087 for 1.75 and 2-inch round cages. If you have 18088 for ProFit cages instead, click in the top right corner for your installation video. This process will take 30 minutes to an hour. First, you want to make sure that you have everything you need to get started. You'll have the mirror components of two wired mirrors, a driver and passenger side clamp, a set of shims, two rubber washers, two metal washers, and two M10 by 25 millimeter socket head bolts. You'll also have the light components of a main harness, a splitter, and two extension cables. The tools you'll need from your shop are an 8 millimeter Allen wrench, a 10 millimeter socket, a 14 millimeter socket, a flathead screwdriver, and a pack of zip ties. You might need a Dremel if your vehicle's dashboard is not equipped with knockouts. If you have issues with anything straight out of the box, please contact us at the address above and we'll fix you right up. So first you'll want to open up your clamp and add your shim. For a 2-inch roll cage, use the shim with the 2 on it. For a 1.875 and 1.75 roll cage, use the shim that's blank. Put the shim square protrusion in the square inlay of the clamp and it should fit inside perfectly. Then close the clamp onto the cage. Take your metal washer and put it on a socket head bolt. Then put the bolt through the hole from the inside of the cage and place the rubber washer on the other side. Bring your mirror up to the bolt, choose your back and forth mirror angle like this, then bolt the mirror tight with your Allen wrench. Push the Allen and the mirror together while you do this. Make sure you have the right mirror for each side. The light pod will always be on the bottom half of the mirror housing. Now repeat all this with your remaining mirror to complete your set. If you want to tighten the folding feature of the mirror, you can find the adjustment nut under the top or bottom cap. If you can't push the mirror back and forth into the different detents, loosen the adjustment nut until the mirror can move through the detent settings. The tighter it is, the more it'll stay put, but it'll be harder for it to break away when you inevitably hit a tree. If you want to adjust the mirror glass, you'll need to pop off the back accent panel from the narrow side with the flathead. Loosen the nut until you can adjust the mirror glass angle, then tighten it back up while holding the glass where you want it to be. And wha-pow! You now have your mirrors! Onto the lights! To review, your light components are two extension cables, a splitter, and a main harness, including a switch, a fuse, a positive red terminal it's connected to, and a negative black terminal. To get started, make sure that your vehicle is off and that your battery is disconnected by removing the negative battery terminal. You'll want to locate your battery and uncover it so the terminals are accessible. For this Razor, there's a pulse bar that's under the dash's storage cubby. Every vehicle is different, so your connection site might be somewhere else. Once you've done that, take your wires from the bottom of the mirrors and route the wires to where your main harness will live. We routed them by taking them through a small gap near the cage trim and pulling it through the body into the pulse bar area. Again, your process might look way different based on your vehicle. Speaking of routing wires, be mindful through the process. Be sure to route them neatly, out of the way of pedals or anything that could catch on your feet, keeping extra cable as bundled as possible. If you're wondering why there's so much darn cable, it's to accommodate suicide-style doors. Now find your main harness. Attach the main harness rings to the pulse bar terminals by taking the nut off the terminal, placing the corresponding ring on the bolt, then reattaching the nut to secure the ring in place. Make sure to place the red with red and black with black. We recommend keeping the wiring tidy and out of the way, but also accessible should you ever blow a fuse or need to troubleshoot problems. Now bridge the gap between these two by connecting the splitter harness on the mirrors to the main harness. Now we'll install the switch. In this vehicle, there are knockout switch holes. If you have these, all you have to do is pry the plastic cap off with a flathead screwdriver or something of the like. If you don't have these, you'll have an outline of one instead, and you'll need to cut out the plastic area with a Dremel or whatever else you want to make the hole. Use this link if you need help with this. Once you have your hole ready, disconnect the colored wires from the back of the switch and route them through the switch hole, from the inside of the vehicle towards the outside. Now you can reattach your wires to the switch. Make sure that the red wire is always in the middle. The blue and yellow wires correspond to the white and green lights respectively. You can change the placement later if you want to change which is up and which is down on the switch. Now secure the switch into the hole. Make sure you've secured any remaining wiring before considering yourself done. You can zip tie your wires to other non-moving components of the vehicles. Now, close up your pulse bar area to close up shop. And of course, the most satisfying part? Oh yes! Now try it out. reconnect your battery, flip the switch, and see what happens. Middle position will be off, and the up and down positions will be either white or green. If your lights aren't working off the bat, it could be a blown fuse, your wire connections, or your battery. If you have to change anything once you're done, make sure to disconnect the battery again before proceeding. You have two wear items on this mirror, the detent insert and your adjustable mirror glass. Lucky for you, all you have to do is call us for your free replacements and you can put them back in lickety-split. Start the process by contacting customer support so we can get the new parts to you. Over time, the mirror detent insert could wear out and not hold position well. If you notice that, it's time to replace. First, look under the caps, then remove the nut. Next, remove the mirror housing containing the washer and spring. The detent insert can now be gently pried off the bolt underneath and replaced with a new one. Now, if you can imagine, sometimes riders will break their mirror glass. We don't really know how, but when it happens, this replacement looks a lot like what happens when you want to adjust the mirror glass. Pry off the mirror's back cap, take off the nut and washers, then the glass and the attached bolt will easily come out of the housing. You can now put in the new glass bolt, then the washers, then the nut. Be aware of the square part of the mirror glass bolt that corresponds with the square in the mirror housing. Now tighten it while holding your mirror glass at the angle you'll want it, just like when you make an adjustment. Again, if anything happens to your mirrors, please let us know, because they're backed with Seismic's famous unlimited lifetime warranty. We'll fix it for free forever. Have any other questions? You know the drill. Contact customer support. And if you want to stay in the loop with Seismic, make sure to check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Thanks for watching, and we hope your next ride is lit.